Captain's Log, Stardate 090816.5. In an attempt to stop the real-time aspect of a final unity from taking over and forcing us into the next situation before we could speak with Shanok, I have reconvened at LP18-2. I believe. Hold on a second. Yes, LP18-2 to replay the events, and at which point we will head for Horst 3 automatically per Commander Riker's suggestion. And we get to ask him that other question, Chancellor LaRocque, and as it is, which we missed out on the first time. And now we'll have Picard actually talk to him.
Thank you for allowing us to beam down.
I welcome you in the Lawgiver's name.
So I'm going to be skipping through all his explanations, which are probably going to be the same.
How did the Romulans manage to find you?
The Garidians and the Romulans are allies.
Why would the Romulans be interested in Phrygis?
At first, we thought they wanted to help their allies by forcing us to return to
Your world appears to be intact. This is the question we missed last episode.
Your world appears to be intact. I trust there was no damage from the Romulan vessel.
The Romulans were not as courteous as you were, so we never let down our defenses. They were unable to penetrate our chameleon field, and they left without inflicting any damage.
Okay, so the chameleon field is not only an illusionary device, but provides actual physical protection as well? Possibly. Or it just gave them the illusion that there was nobody there, possibly. I'm not even sure.
The ancient Chodak have suddenly assumed great importance in galactic affairs. We were hoping you could tell us some more about them.
Our people have always been fascinated by the ruins.
What do you know about Chodak society?
Their empire spanned this quadrant in
It's unusual for such an immense empire to last that long. What was the secret of their success?
Again, I'm just skipping through all this because we heard all this last time, but it's cool to hear Picard, you know, actually say the lines. So I'll keep his in.
They had a talent for administration.
What else do you know about Chodak history?
We believe that the group which settled here and built these structures was not from the mainstream of Chodak society.
Why do you say that?
For one reason, this is a very small base.
And for another?
The Chodak settlers often refer to Alinor as the seat of evil.
Perhaps the settlers here were similar to your own ancestors, fleeing an established society to pursue a different vision.
That's a different line. I don't believe Data said that.
Perhaps. But I suspect the Chodak here played a far more active role. This outpost was only inhabited for a few decades, which coincided almost exactly with the end of the Empire as a whole.
These reasons are not strong grounds for believing the settlers here were rebels.
There are a thousand more small clues, all pointing to the same conclusion.
What is this mystery?
A century ago, our scientists found a Chodak data crystal.
Perhaps the Enterprise's computers could read your Chodak data crystal safely.
Very well. I will entrust the crystal to you.
What do you know about Chodak technology?
We do not fully understand the principles behind it.
What else have you discovered about Chodak technology?
They had an unusual way of navigating.
Is there anything else you can tell me about Chodak technology?
They created special shielding materials.
What else have you discovered?
They used devices similar to isolinear rods as keys.
How does it work?
When this programmer is twisted around the rod's end.
Is there anything else?
The crowning glory of their technology.
Do you have any more details about this Unity device?
I think it was a superweapon with almost unlimited powers.
If you'll excuse me, I have other duties to attend to. Perhaps we can talk again later.
As you wish. May the spirit of the Lawgiver guide your path through the stars.
We've done all we can here. Beam us up.
Make it so.
Chancellor LaRocque was most helpful. We now know what the Romulans are seeking.
Do you think the Romulans have really found the Unity device?
We'd know already if they had.
Mm-hmm.
The device is that powerful?
I'm not sure.
What are your orders, Captain?
Horst 3, warp 5.
Set course for Horst 3, warp 5.
Aye, sir.
This is what I was afraid I was missing, so...
Engage.
Warp 5. I might increase this. Not sure how far away we are. Pretty far away. Warp 8.
Engage.
Captain, the ship's computer has completed its attempt to read the damaged Chodak data.
Any success, Mr. Data?
Only in part, sir. As Chancellor Larac guessed, Phrygis was indeed a rebel base. The rebels used a programmable encryption rod. There is then a corrupted section and a brief mention of a space freighter called the Rinkel. The complete text of the information may, of course, be found in the ship's computer.
Let's go there first. I'm afraid that if we look at the computer entry, that might be what causes us to be redirected to this other sector where the mysterious invaders are coming, which...
Helm, standard orbit.
...may be the Chodak themselves. Ah, see, I didn't want to miss this.
Captain's log. We have arrived at Horse 3 to request some advice from the noted Vulcan archaeologist, Shanok.
Excellent.
Instead, all we have found here is a recorded message boy broadcasting continuously.
Hmm.
To whoever hears this message, the sudden incursion into this region of space by a flotilla of Romulan warships has made this remote expedition untenable. For the safety of my crew, I have decided to abandon this site temporarily.
Mm-hmm.
In the name of science, I ask that you do not disturb my work on this planet. There is one site that requires special care. The Chodak site seems to have a field that camouflages it to normal sensors. I located it mostly by accident.
Chameleon thing.
There is a platform jutting out partway down a deep shaft in the ground. Further investigation has been blocked by an ancient rock slide.
Let's beam down to the surface and blast it with phasers and see what we can find.
As much as I would like to honor Shanok's request to leave the site alone, we don't have that luxury. The current situation makes it imperative that we learn where this planet Alanor is. This Chodak base may have the information we need.
Right. So at the end of the last episode, we were ordered to another sector by Admiral Williams. Now I wonder, if I had not gone back to LP-18-2, would I have been able to see this at all, or would this have been cut out of my gameplay? Or would we perhaps go here after encountering these mysterious vessels?
We should form an away team at once to investigate this shaft that Shanok spoke of, but we'll have to be careful to disturb as little on the site as possible.
Indeed.
Any suggestions, number one?
I'm sorry, Captain, I don't...
Mr. Data, any suggestions?
I suggest...
Okay, never mind. Transporter. Before we're interrupted by Starfleet. Okay, we got Picard again. Good. Data. LaForge.
Beam down coordinates selected.
And Troy. Oh, we've got the rod with us. Okay. We haven't even looked at this thing, like, as far as in-game. Or with the gameplay element, whatever you call it. Energize. Interesting. Interesting music as well. Oh, look at this thing. Isolinear rod.
This isolinear rod might help us use Chodak technology.
Mm-hmm.
This is used to program the Chodak isolinear rod.
Mm-hmm.
This chasm extends as far down as I can see. Those spires are fascinating. I wonder whether they're natural, or whether the Chodak sculpted them that way.
That is a very appropriate thing. I don't know what to say. I would wonder the same. I am wondering the same, actually.
Chancellor Larac said this isolinear rod is a key to unlock certain Chodak apparatus.
Apparatus? One of my favorite words.
This device can be used to alter the code of the Chodak isolinear rod. Deep pits seem to be a motif in the Chodak architectural style.
Yeah, really. Spire.
It is possible those formations were sculpted by the Chodak.
Mm-hmm. So I haven't had anything to look at other than this chasm and the spire. Wait, stars and sky, oh.
The thin, dry atmosphere on this planet makes it an exceptional site for astronomical observation.
Get another line out of Picard here.
I wonder if the Chodak deliberately chose a site with such a good view of the sky.
Right. I wonder if the spires are supposed to point towards a particular star.
This rod could come in pretty handy if we ever need to unlock any Chodak mechanisms.
Interesting, yep.
We can adjust the code of the isolinear rod with this device. I don't know if these formations are natural, but they're certainly impressive.
That they are, Mr. LaForge.
It's hard to imagine that most of the stars up there were all once part of the Chodak Empire.
Hmm.
It's sure a long way down.
Watch that first step. It's a doozy.
I'm glad this platform is solid.
Huh.
This rod can act like an electronic skeleton key for Chodak equipment.
That's what I was calling it, a skeleton rod.
This is used to program the Chodak isolinear rod.
Hmm.
I'm glad this platform is solid.
Did that run already?
It's a beautiful night.
Aw, isn't it?
These formations are certainly impressive.
Some things are a lot more echoed than others.
This Chodak site is unique within the Federation's borders. We must explore it as carefully as we possibly can.
Agreed.
This site has the potential to significantly advance our knowledge of the Chodak. We should investigate everything carefully. This site...
LaForge. Oh, I had it.
This site could really help us understand Chodak technology better. We should examine everything carefully.
Mm-hmm. Where is she? Troy?
Unlike the ruins on Phrygis, this site has been unused for thousands of centuries. We could learn a lot about the Chodak if we explore carefully.
Mm-hmm. Talk to Chasm. Hello, down there.
That won't help now. I cannot use this with that.
Oh, can we use that with this, then?
I cannot use this with that.
Mm-hmm. Let's examine the rod with the tricorder.
No unusual readings.
We should be getting something unusual. We've never seen anything like this before.
No unusual readings.
Alrighty then. Use platform? Oh. Oh, we can look at the platform. I didn't notice that. Oh, rubble we have also? Missed that.
This platform dates back to the Chodak Empire. We may be standing on the brink of an important discovery.
Hmm.
I wonder if there could be anything behind this pile of rubble.
Yeah, we're gonna blast that with our phasers, probably like I thought. See what anyone else has to say about the platform and rubble.
Forcing people to beam to this one site is an excellent way to defend it.
Aha, good point.
Perhaps there is something behind that pile of rocks.
I'm not sure whether I'm standing on a welcome mat or a castle drawbridge.
Geordi's awesome.
It looks like a cave-in covered up something behind that pile of rocks.
I feel a little exposed standing out here like this.
Hmm.
I wonder if we'd find anything if we cleared away that rubble.
Okay. Data, I'll let you do the honors. Did that clear? Can we walk through that?
Perhaps there is something behind that pile of rocks.
Is there a gap now? We have to blast it more, I guess. Oh wait, we're on stun, aren't we? You know, I tend to think red is the highest setting. Here, let's just increase this all the way. Cool. Let's put it back to stun. So I inadvertently kill something that we could actually, you know, not destroy completely.
There appears to be more to explore in this direction.
I think there's more to see down this passageway.
I think there's more to see down this way.
It looks as though there might be more to see down this passageway.
Whatever gives you that idea? Let's save. Because stuff. Don't walk off the edge, Picard. Cad. We got small. I was afraid we were getting that bug again where people walk into dwindling size and just disappear. End up having, you know, the away team existing at a subatomic level. Alright.
Look, a shooting star. On Earth, that means you get to make a wish.
Oh god, Diana.
Shooting star is actually a misnomer.
Right.
In reality, they are simply meteors which are incinerated as they enter a planet's atmosphere.
Then again, Data can be quite a killjoy, can he?
I know, Data, and rainbows are just the refraction of light by water droplets. But they're still beautiful.
True that. Let's look at stuff. We got a generator. We have access shaft.
This passageway leads back out to the platform where we beam down.
Generator rear of sight. Wait, what was that? Generator. So apparently, at least, we've got the access shaft, the generator, and the rear of the site.
This large piece of machinery is still functioning.
If I hit that, they're probably going to walk up there. Probably. I don't need to talk to this stuff, though.
This is the passageway leading from the beam-down platform into the site itself.
Mm-hmm.
This appears to be a field generator of some type. However, I am unfamiliar with this design.
What a coincidence. So am I.
This is the path we used to get in here after we cleared away the rocks.
They have excellent memories, don't they?
This is definitely a field generator, but I'd have to study it more closely before I could give you any details.
Mm-hmm.
This is the way we came in. This looks like some kind of field generator.
Even Troy knows it's a field generator.
That panel over by the wall looks as though it might prove interesting.
To the rear of the site? Oh, there's a screen. We need a selectable key. And I guess this is the panel? Is the screen?
The panel on the wall may have served an important function at one time.
Hmm.
I'd like to take a closer look at that panel by the wall.
We all love the panel on the wall.
That panel against the wall looks interesting. I wonder what it does.
Probably something sufficiently panel-like. Look at screen blank.
The Chodak must have used this screen to display information.
Hmm.
Fascinating.
The exit is fascinating.
It appears this screen is meant to display information to the user. Intriguing.
This looks like an information display. The question is, what kind of information is it supposed to display?
Aperture.
We might be able to get the panel working if we can figure out what goes in this aperture.
The rod, perhaps?
The screen probably displayed some kind of information.
I wonder if it gives you that idea.
Hmm. Maybe some other part of the panel is missing.
What'd I miss?
This looks as though some kind of tool needs to be placed into it.
Ding, ding, ding.
This aperture indicates that some element may be missing from the panel.
I forgot to have LaForge check the exit.
I don't see anything special about it.
Well, everyone else was so interested in it. I know the rod goes in there. Let's see about the rear of the site. Use the rear. No, look at it.
There's more equipment over on that side of the room.
There appear to be scientific instruments on the other side of the room.
There's some more equipment over there.
There's more equipment over there.
Over there, man, over there. Oh, we're gonna have her use it. Have him use it. Picard. Alright. Use the rod on the aperture. We have to attach this too, don't we?
Fascinating.
Cool. Now that's really fascinating. Can I put this back? Thank you.
Fascinating.
Oh god.
Intriguing.
I don't see anything.
Nothing special about it, really? What if I use this again? Back to... Alright, it's just the same. Okay. So is this a map of some kind? Or is this... Are these sectors? Different stars and such. Kind of looks like part of the cube. What do you call it, cube? Can't remember the name of it. That we used to look at all the sectors and such. You guys know what I'm talking about. Let's use the exit. Let's walk to the rear of the site and see what other goodies there are. Interesting. Another pit. Endless pit. Oh, got an instrument. We got stuff. Instrument. Instrument mounting. A pit. Anything else? Pit. Just want to miss anything. We got instrument mounting and a pit. Alright.
If I were to speculate, I would say that this particular site was used for making astronomical observations.
That would explain why this outpost is so far from the main body of the Chodak Empire. Perhaps they were attempting to make clean observations, uncontaminated by interference from their own transmissions.
That data's so smart.
Let's record as much as we can. Our computer can analyze the data and make sense out of it later.
Which means use our tricorders.
This is the energy source that keeps the site running. This structure keeps the instrument at its front end aimed correctly.
Indeed.
This looks like a device for analyzing and recording astronomical observations.
The power source appears to still be functioning.
It sure does.
I believe this structure is designed to hold a scientific instrument steady and aim it accurately at its target. This device is similar to a subspace phase spectrometer, which is normally used to measure the intervals between subspace phase fluctuations.
Definitely a lot more than the good captain said.
It's incredible. An energy source still working after 900,000 years.
Yeah, right.
I think this is a mounting for an instrument to hold it steady while you take your measurements. The device is like a subspace phase spectrometer. We use them to measure the intervals between subspace phase pulses.
Looking at stars, in other words.
There must be an energy source down there. I'm not sure what this is.
I think it was duly explained.
I'm not sure what this is.
As was that. Anything else to say here?
Since everything here could be a clue about the Chodak, we had better be careful about examining everything thoroughly.
If we hope to learn anything valuable about the Chodak, we should examine everything we find very closely.
This is clearly a scientific base. I want to check out everything here very carefully. We might find some clues about the Chodak.
Yes, yes. Can I get to Troy?
I'm sorry, but I don't have any suggestions right now.
Oh, God. It would be...
There's a lot of scientific equipment in this part of the site.
It would be unanimous.
This must be the heart of the station. We must be especially careful to examine everything we find in detail.
Right. Which means using the tricorder.
This chasm descends to a depth of about 3.5 kilometers. For some reason, this was used to keep its instrument constantly pointed at one specific object in the sky. This is a highly advanced subspace phase spectrometer. I understand it's used by astronomers to measure the interval between certain subspace fluctuations.
I don't know why it makes that sound afterwards now.
Readings indicate that this chasm is 3.487 kilometers deep. The walls are composed primarily of igneous rocks.
They're using energy from the planet's core, aren't they?
Knowing where this instrument was pointed may help us determine what the Chodak were attempting to study. This instrument is set to measure the interval between certain subspace fluctuations.
The bottom's almost 3.5 kilometers down. Once we know where the Chodak were pointing this mounting, we can figure out what they were looking at.
Just trying to get all the dialogue we can.
The device was set up to measure the time between certain subspace pulses.
This chasm goes down 3.5 kilometers. This mounting is fixed to point at one particular spot. I'm not sure what to make of these readings.
All right, what if we have data? Use the mounting?
I do not believe that will work.
Use the instrument.
I do not believe that will work. I do not believe that will work.
Okay. I don't think there's anything else we can do here. We can't use any of this stuff. I didn't think we could. But we took readings of everything. So...
There's a lot of scientific equipment in this part of the site.
Well, besides the pit, just two things, which is actually one piece of equipment.
This must be the heart of the station.
They're gonna keep saying that. Now we can... Look at that. Maybe data can help analyze this better.
Intriguing.
Alright, let's use a tricorder here as well.
Some of the data has been corrupted over time. However, I believe the ship's computer can still extract a great deal of information.
I'd like to get this information into the ship's computer and find out what it is.
So would I.
I'm not sure what to make of these readings.
Oh, God.
Even though some of the data has been corrupted over time, our computer can probably deduce a wealth of helpful information from it.
Why do we even bring Troy with us? What the hell? Anything else?
The panel on the wall may have served an important function at one time.
Is that the panel? Just gotta keep walking back and forth.
I'd like to take a closer look at that panel by the wall.
I guess we haven't examined the panel.
That panel against the...
Must be something small. Not the screen, but a panel. Which wall? You know what? Let's use a tricorder on the generator as well.
This is generating a field at the same frequencies as our sensors.
Based on these readings, I suspect this is the device which generates the chameleon field.
pretty cool.
This device generates the chameleon field that disguises the station when you look at it from space.
Is it running?
I'm not sure what to make of these readings.
Oh god. You know, I thought the screen is the panel, but they're still talking about it. Rear of sight. It said it was on a wall. I mean, this is a wall. Use the generator?
That's not working.
Huh.
I do not believe that will work.
Panel. Hmm.
That panel over by the wall looks as though it might prove interesting.
Panel by the wall. I'm assuming they may mean this panel. Not even sure. Just goes over to it anyway.
My readings indicate this mechanism may still be operational.
Ah, he's walking. Just want to see if we get anything this way.
Under the right circumstances, I might be able to make this thing work.
I don't know why I'm bothering to let her use it.
I'm not sure, but we might be able to get this to work.
Many of the components are still operational. We might be able to get this to work.
Let's try this again. Same.
It did not work.
Yeah.
Even though some of the data has been corrupted over time.
Alright, I'm hoping. Let's grab this back. I'm hoping this is all we have to do. I haven't analyzed this stuff, have I? Oh, not that.
No anomalous reading.
This chasm descends to a depth of about 3.5 kilometers.
No unusual readings.
Beam us up.
I've already saved. I hope we'll find out something.
Captain's log. The archaeological site on Horst remains a fascinating mystery. I'm hoping that our ship's computer will be able to analyze the tricorder data we discovered at the Chodak site and tell us quickly what we need to know.
Sensors are picking up a vessel.
Evasive maneuvers.
Aye, Captain.
Go to red alert.
A Romulan warbird
is
on sensors.
Decloaking.
Locking weapons. We are being hailed.
Do you need a moment, Captain?
Brother.
You know as well as I that our ships are evenly matched.
I am...
Enemy ship is firing. Torpedo
locked.
I am very much interested in being destroyed by you.
We have been hit.
Do you need a moment, Captain?
My crew and I are prepared to sacrifice ourselves.
We shall...
The enemy has engaged its self-destruct sequence. Direct fire.
I was about to hit both.
The Romulan warbird has been destroyed.
Mr. Data, any suggestions?
I suggest we contact Starfleet, Captain.
Any suggestions, number one?
I'm sorry, Captain, I don't...
Primary core access enabled. Systems online.
The site was temporarily abandoned after the Romulan fleet invaded Federation space. Further exploration by the Enterprise crew revealed evidence of a still-functioning astronomical observatory. Further analysis of the star chart found at the site revealed the location of Alinor, the central administration world for the Chodak Empire. Found the recorded message buoy. So I guess we never were at Horst III. I thought Horst III was the planet with the different animals and such. So here's the information on the data crystal. Isolinear rod. Ah! Tricorder analysis. The units in question include a scientific instrument and a rigid mounting that holds it in place. The mounting is set on motorized gimbals moving in a pattern calculated to keep the instrument constantly pointed at a given position in the sky. With no established longitudinal standard for Horst III, the instrument was arbitrarily defined as being the zero longitude referent. By local celestial coordinates, the instrument was pointed at plus 42 degrees 18... I don't know what this stands for. 18 minutes, 37 seconds, I don't even know. O0H. The instrument in question was of alien design, incorporating the functions of several known instruments used throughout the Federation, most notably a subspace phase spectrometer. The instrument was calibrated to measure variations in the subspace bandwidths G through K, as well as to calculate the frequency of such variations. There are no star systems within Federation space along that line of coordinates. The nearest known star system along those coordinates is over 55,000 light-years distant from Horst III. The coordinates do intersect an arm of the Zarnas Nebula, however, which expanded into that region nearly 700,000 years ago. It is possible some uncharted object may exist along that line within the nebula itself. Cool.
Any suggestions, number one?
I'm sorry, Captain,
We know stuff now.
Mr. Data, any suggestions?
I suggest we contact Starfleet, Captain.
Let's contact Starfleet. Let's see if they have anything to say, if we can tell them anything.
Admiral Williams here. What can I do for you, Captain?
What is the current situation, Admiral?
The Romulan incursion is all but over. We think they may be after a legendary super weapon built by the ancient Chodak.
Yes, they've seen this all before. Said this all before.
I'd like to confirm our current orders.
Of course. Your orders are to investigate the real reasons behind the Romulan incursion.
Assessment?
What's your assessment of our recent performance?
I'm pleased to note that you contacted the Klingon attack cruiser Bortas.
Yeah.
Captain Kedra was able to... Shall I go on?
No, thank you.
No, thank you.
Picard out.
Okay. Gotta call an episode now.
Sir, on screen.
Oh, never mind.
Greetings, Admiral. What can we do for you?
So this is the way the previous episode ended.
An unknown alien race has just crossed the neutral zone into Federation space. All attempts to communicate with them have failed.
Are they hostile?
Definitely.
Do we have any idea of their objectives?
That's the strangest part.
Then my first instinct would be to let them go with our blessings.
I wish we could.
Understood. Picard out.
What are your orders, Captain?
Set course for the Yaj system. Maximum warp. Engage.
Okay. Gonna be a longer episode. Or it is a longer episode. Just in case I missed anything here. Gonna save as a different, separate file. 20-2. I have a feeling we have to be very careful with this, so... gonna mess around and ruminate and stuff and see if we, missed anything, possibly. The panel bothers me, that they call it a panel, but we only saw a screen. So, anyway, see you next time, when we'll either be back on the planet, in the ruins, or we'll be advancing to whatever star system she told us to go to. Thanks for watching, see you next time, and endure. In enduring, grow strong.